Welcome to tonight's game between the Michigan State Spartans and the Indiana Hoosiers. Number 23 is a player who deserves our attention in this contest tonight.
He's one of the best young players in the country, Brad. He's a great scorer and a great defender. He can really control both ends of the floor.
The Hoosiers will certainly want to take advantage of his presence on the floor. The Hoosiers should be in for a tough one tonight, Dick. What do you see as the keys to their success?
The keys are very simple, my friend. Number one, play at your own tempo. Don't get into a run-and-gun game, baby. Second, work the ball to the interior to your post players. Let them be your option number one offensively. Thirdly, make sure you take care of the rock. Turnovers kill momentum.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. The center with the ball. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Down inside. He went for the steal in the post and he missed it there.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He makes the shot. Go into the low block and up. They still don't score. Oh, yes. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off. Up and inside.
Now trying to feed the low block. Spence picks up the foul. First personal foul. There's a double team waiting there. He keeps his dribble as they reset.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. That's a foul. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad. Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
He makes the second. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Picks off the pass. Gave it up. On the dribble, gives it up. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Trying to feed the low block. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He goes to the line. Terrible free throw. Makes the second shot.
With anticipation defensively.
The point guard gets the ball. Goes up for two. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders with a great block. The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
You can't forget about them. The witty humor and dedication to their teams. You can't find this in any other team sport. What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
The small forward takes the pass. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Looking for a good shot. He looks for three. Sinks the shot.
How about an instant replay?
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Dickey's doing a nice job defensively fronting it.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in man.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Defensively trying to stay with his man, and he's going to pick up a foul.
What a poor job defensively. Very slow inside, and they attack him aggressively.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Indiana are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Got a wide open look. They work the perimeter. Gave it up. He goes for three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's getting it done out there, Brad. They'd be in trouble without him. That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Hobbs in the paint.
There he is. Strips the ball loose.
They work it around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint. Puts it up looking for contact.
They scored 7 in a row. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Trying to draw the foul.
He did a great job recognizing the double team.
On the outside, the shooting guard gets the pass. He hits the shot.
Look at that spacing. A little frustration right there.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. From left of the circle, tickles a twine. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Spence pump fakes.
Nice fake.
Tries for two. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
He takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's one you take for the team, Brad.
He steps up to the line. He gets it to go. Jumped in front to take it away. Here's the offensive drop step and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Here they go into the break. Trying to draw some contact. perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up.
There's the trap.
Got the high pick. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Gave it up. With the fake, he shoots from the angle. Goes in. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Taken away. Here they come now on a turnover for the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Wheeler is emotionally pumped up.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
Nelson, foul plus the bucket. Big time play on that one, Dick.
You said it, Brad.
He sure does, Dick, and why not? He and his team have all the momentum. I can't wait to see what unfolds next.
Hey, he wants everyone to get up.
Number 34 gets in on his first minutes tonight.
Hey, this kid really knows how to keep the offense moving. Tremendous leader out there.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
For two, perfectly executed.
Dump it inside.
On the dribble, gives it up, jumps in.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
The Hoosiers have a special roster, which I know you're in love with.
Oh, their roster is pretty special, Brad. You know why? Because of the seniors, the leaders, the dependable ones. They're so important.
And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Up for two. Perfectly executed.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
10 on the shot clock. And off, he gets the rejection. And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Brad and Dick, there is a sense of concern on the bench right now. The coaching staff fears if the other players don't get involved soon, it may be too late. He keeps stressing to his team, I can't do this by myself, so help me out. We'll have to continue to monitor this one, guys, along the way.
Turns it over. Pushes it up. With a quarterback pass.
Slam jam dab, up and away, the elevator man, they love it.
Working it around the perimeter.
That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane, anticipating really well.
They work it around the perimeter. Spence comes up with it. The point guard takes the feed. That's one of the best parts of college basketball, the student section. They're fired up and they're ready to try to help their team.
Isn't it great, Brad?
Here's Here's a double team. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Knocks it down. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper.
Up and inside.
Ball was loose, but the offense got it back. They work the perimeter. On the outside. On the outside. Offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket. There it is, Jam City.
Steals a pass. Launches the three. Drains it. Looking for a good shot. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Gave it up. Gets the rejection. Another turnover.
And we're not talking apple turnovers either.
Leans in, and he scores despite the hack.
Up and inside.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Working it around the perimeter. The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
They're on fire, Dick, from behind the arc.
I'd like to see how long they can keep this up.
The Hoosiers still have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
And in and out. He puts it in with contact and all.
Brad, this crowd will be in a frenzy if they can get a basket on this possession.
For two. Doesn't go. Goes up for two. Picked out of the air. Puts up the tray. He gets the bucket to fall. Intercepted. Had a momentary look from three-point land. On the dribble, gives it up.
Up and inside.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Three, the perimeter. He looks at the hoop. For three, it sticks.
You gotta let the offense play into the double.
Yeah, they may be forcing the double a little bit. Gave it up. Jumps into the defender. Hobbs makes the finger roll. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job, front. Rejects it. Count that as a personal foul. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me? I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often. Can't. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
That's a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Dick, when I see those types of things, I just get chills.
The man is off the charts, Brad.
When I think of home court advantage, this is what I see and this is what I hear. The crowd's fired up, and I'm sure the team is too. And now with a power move, he blocks the shot. There they come with a double team to stop it. Let's it fly. Drains the shot. The Spartans have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
Goes up for two. They'll work it around the arc. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Now they work it around the perimeter. Looking for contact. Easy one.
Roll it back, fellas. Let's see if they go two for one here, Brad.
Gave it up. Takes away the pass. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
He attempts a jump hook.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
Working it around the perimeter on the inside. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Looking for a good shot. Takes the pass in the paint for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. At the end of the first half, the Spartans are behind by 11. It's a close one, folks. What have you got, Dick, as your play of the half?
There were some good highlights in that first half, but you got to look at this one. Watch how they got the ball inside for easy scores, which forced the defense to collapse, opening up the perimeter game.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. Indiana is showing some deadly accuracy from the field in the first half.
Hey, for sure, Brad. This kind of accuracy can easily be carried over to the second half if they continue to be patient with the rock. Patience and poise usually equals points.
Dick started the second half. We take a look at our focus player, and he's going to have to be the man to come through.
Well, I think he's got to attack the basket a lot more. I think he's got to get opportunities to go to the free throw line, and that'll come if he becomes aggressive. I tell you, terrific shot. Really impossible to get a piece of that baby.
What's up the shot? Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
Scorches the net with a J.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. On the dribble, gives it up.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
High post player flashing.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad. Oh, he got to knock those down. Great screen, but no go.
They work the perimeter. Dumps it in. Blocks the shot. Here we go on the break. Tries for two. That's good.
My goodness, Mr. Nelson, that was phenomenal, baby.
Look at that student body. They are going mad.
Aren't they great, Brad? I love it.
Obvious foul. You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all had good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt play is.
And he doesn't miss that opportunity either.
Inside.
He unloads. Indiana are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they have to keep pushing and seeing if they can't force a timeout.
For the bucket.
I love this guy, Hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
They work it around the perimeter. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
There's a high screen.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad, some of the players told me before the game they felt their biggest key was to get the ball inside. They said, we have the personnel to score in the paint, and that's what makes us a big threat.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, you know, great post play, you got a chance really to win.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. Looking for the foul. Puts it up, looking for contact. Michigan State are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
He fakes the shot.
High post screen.
Blocks it. Doesn't go. He intercepts it. Tries for two, and off the mark. Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal. He didn't have the good angle. They should have gotten it to him about a second earlier.
Trying to draw the foul. Perfectly executed.
That's an 8-zip run.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Basket falls despite the contact. For the bucket. And in and out. The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Well, Dick, what's the front court production looking like to you?
Well, you know, Brad, your bigs really can influence how your teams play. Rebound, blocking shots, altering shots are all very important skills which your big players should possess.
For two, the Spartans have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brad, he's on fire.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Sets a screen for his teammate. He shoots from the top of the key. That was nice. The Spartans trail by five. And one too many dribbles and a steal. Looking for a good shot. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He's open if he wants the shot. He bombs from outside. The Hoosiers are ahead by eight. On the outside. Entry pass in the paint. Makes the shot. They work the perimeter. The shooting guard takes the pass in the paint.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Time to pick up the defense here now.
They strip them in the basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'm telling you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
Fakes it.
Oh, what a strip, Brad.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Up and in.
Little showtime. It's going to be a three-point play. Got the foul. The bench loves it.
Check that out. He's pumping up the crowd. He wants him to turn it up a notch.
He says, show me some love. I'm working my tail off here.
He goes to the free throw line. He hits it. This is home court advantage at its best. The crowd, the students, everyone is feeling good. turnaround jumper. Dickey Sibley on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Goes up for two.
Great job of running the defender into the screen for the nice J.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The Hoosiers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Picks off the lazy pass. Trying to draw some contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Trying to make a statement. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back over to you.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Gets it to Paul.
Definitely worth another look, Brad.
Indiana, they really love their hoops. Basketball in Indiana has even inspired a movie or two.
Well, the mentality in Indiana is basketball. They're really passionate about their hoops.
Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
Both.
Oh, he drained it. That's on the nylon. NBN.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
That is a great play. These kids have all the momentum now. Look at them. They're celebrating.
Hey, Brad, the kids are fired up and having a lot of fun.
Comes away with it. This defense isn't yielding an inch.
Hey, the offense looks very timid, Brad.
Fake. Good fake. For the bucket. In and out. Second chance coming up. He puts up the three ball. Indiana are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they've put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
For two, they still don't score. Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
It's the replay, please.
Off the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so is the defense, and they do a nice job. Working around the perimeter, way out on top, controlling the ball. He rejects it.
Oh my goodness, that was unbelievable, baby.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Hey,
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Shoots it. Oh, yes.
That double team's too weak, Brad.
Well, they ran through that like it wasn't there. Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere.
The crowd loves this young man.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for him.
Gave it up.
Set that screen away.
And again, they look to run. Tries for two. He nails the shot.
Shot usually creates momentum and opportunities.
He intercepts it. Hobbs picks up the defensive foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
He buries it. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
It's two at the charity stripe. Two. Can't get the shot to drop. Goes up for two. The student section is all rallied up and they are ready to battle.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
Strips the ball.
Oh, what a great job transition. Offense. Poor job defensively. Don't get back. Don't stop the ball. And they're allowed to convert. Get the number game going.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip.
Get that sucker out of the game, man.
They get out on the break. And he scores it off the glass. The Hoosiers are up by 15. Post, but elected to reverse the ball. He fires from long range. Got it. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
Double team now. Bad angle.
Stolen away. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
He launches a three. He gets that one to fall. They move it into the front court. And he scores despite the hack.
Dump it inside.
Entry pass in the paint. The layup.
Right there, they missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
Yeah, as we take a look here at our backcourt production.
Hey, Brown, I'll tell you one thing. Productivity from the backcourt is a must. You must initiate the offense, distribute the ball, and score. These are all things that you rely on your backcourt to do.
Now he faces up on the low block.
I mean, it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
They work it around the perimeter. Jumps in.
Great play to take that to the basket. Gotta take some pride on a defensive end.
From right in the circle, the Hoosiers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
And he's on fire.
For the bucket. Michigan State have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
From the baseline. Can't put it down.
Look at that spacing.
For two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Goes up for two. Rims out.
Nice hops.
Gave it up. Tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
And now they'll bring it up. And we've got a whistle and a foul. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me? Good teams will get to the line often. But getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
He misses it. They're not getting the balls to fall from the line.
Hey, if I were the coach of this team, I would make them run so many lines, I would pass out from watching them run, Brad.
On the outside, from three-point land, he shows the sweet touch. Job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball or let him try to beat us. See who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. And the fans here are loving the action.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Nestler. We are so lucky that we get to go to all these schools and experience the mayhem firsthand.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick.
Right, Brad. They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time. Second shot. Dick, is 10 points safe at this point?
Are you kidding me? 10 scratches wouldn't be safe with half of this time left.
Great defense. And there's guys a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, know when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their teams.
They will line them up. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Sinks it. They work the perimeter. He tries the three ball. He gets the bucket to fall. And the clock stopped with a foul. Well, Mr. Vitale, there's the foul situation so far.
Hey, Brad, staying out of foul trouble down the stretch of any game is vital. You want to keep your opponents off the free throw line and out of bonus situations.
First shot is good. Call on the court. We're ready to get back to the action. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
Oh, screener took some punishment setting that pick. The Hoosiers are now in the double bonus. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock, possession, or their timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Second shot, good. He tries the three. He hits a bullseye again.
Hey, he's feeling it from everywhere, baby.
Oh, and look at the crowd, and look at the reaction.
I think the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
It's good. Both of them. He launches a three. The Spartans have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
The center receives the pass. Goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
On the dribble, gives it up, gave it up. Nelson receives the ball. Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
I tell you one thing, he was sensational. He made all big shots. He really wanted the ball. I thought he was very aggressive offensively.
Indiana walks away as the victor in this very good matchup.
But two teams like this, you knew the game was going to be close.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.